Good morning, students. See, today we shall discuss one of the important study of structure of silicates in the P block elements. Silicon is the group 14 element. Silicon forms, it is the second most abundant element in the earth crust. And it forms silicate. Silicates is one of the most important constituent of the earth crust. Look here, clay or kaolinite, sand or any other important silica minerals. Cement and glass are man-made silicates. Zeolite is a silicate. Soil is a silicate. So there are so many silicates, and all these silicates have a basic unit. The basic unit in every silicate is what, you know, SiO4 4-. This is called silicate. You know what is the structure of this? Tetrahedral structure. Every silicon is surrounded by 4 oxygen atoms in the tetrahedral manner. This is the basic unit in every silicate. Suppose if you write the planar structure for writing the chain structures of silicates, it can be written in this way. For example, watch this. This I will denote with SI, and as this type of circle I will use for oxygen, O2-. Okay, then I can write this like this. The tetrahedron, if you hold the 3 tetrahedron which are towards you or away from you, takes one plane and the other one is in another plane. Maybe you can think like this. Suppose if I hold it towards the observer like this, see, 1, 2, 3, triangular shape you will get. This is a central silicon atom. And this is the oxygen atom. You will get the image there itself. Do you agree or not? This is the tetrahedral structure of silicate. So I'll write it like this. So 1, 2, 3. These are 3 oxygen atoms. O-, O-, O-. Now the central silicon atom, where do you write the 4th oxide ion? This one. So you will write here itself, O-. So this is the planar structure for reference, what you write from the tetrahedral structure. So every silicate is having this basic unit. Now, what about the classification of silicates? Classification. This plays a very important role, especially for JEE and IIT and NEET exams. And in CET, because very less part is there in the textbook about silicates, so this may not be that much expected. Understand? But as far as JEE, NEET and IIT syllabus is, advanced syllabus is considered, I have seen questions on asking the structures of silicate and examples on silicate. They draw a structure and which type of silicate it is, they ask. So that is why I consider this as a separate learning under silicon chapter. Now let us go to classification of syllabus. See, the simplest silicate is arthosilicates. You know what are arthosilicates? These tetrahedral silicate ion is not at all shared with anything, not shared with the other other ions, or you can say discrete silicate ion is present. Normally oxygen or oxide ion is to share with neighboring silicate or other things. It is not going to sharing with any other neighboring silicate ions. Then what about the negative charge? The 4 minus charge of silicate ion is satisfied by cations. So such silicates are there in nature. I see, I will give you some example of arthosilicates. For example, zircon. This is an arthosilicate, zircon. And what is this? The tetravalent zirconium ion Zr4+ satisfy SiO4-. Zirconium is tetravalent here. Silicate is also tetravalent. This is the structure of, or this is the formula of zircon. It is an arthosilicate. Similarly, wellimite is one silicate, arthosilicate, and it is certain zinc silicate. It is SiO4. Zinc is 2+, you know, therefore it is Zn2. Phenacite is another arthosilicate. Phenacite is another arthosilicate, and its formula Be2SiO4. This is one of the common variety of silicates. Understand? And this is the simplest of all the silicates. Remember, discrete tetrahedral SiO4 4 minus ions are present, whose oxide ions are not shared with any of the neighboring silicate molecules. Remember, the sharing is like this. Every silicon is surrounded by 4 oxygen atoms, and every oxygen atom is surrounded by 2 silicon atoms, because oxygen is divalent. That is the way it shares. But here oxide ion is linked to only one silicon. Only one silicon, not sharing. That is arthosilicate. Hope you understood what is arthosilicate. Okay. Yes. Now, next little bit. Now, let us start building the silicate structures. The higher silicate, that is called pyrosilicate. Once again, I remind you, what is the discrete unit in arthosilicate? Can you tell me? Yes, sir. O4-. Now, pyrosilicate. Look here. Two of the silicate ions share one oxygen common. Let me try the structure. Yes, sir. O-. Yes, sir. O-. Now, let them share one oxygen. See this. This minus charge disappears. This is a covalent bond now. So, what is this structure? What is the formula? Can you tell me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, sir. 2. O7, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. O7. 1, 2, 3, 6 minus. These are all very, very important. Not this. What is the structure of pyrosilicate? What is the common unit of pyrosilicate? SiO2, 076 minus, this is 568. How do you write this form of structure? Hope you will now follow, because see, all the four oxide ions are shown, 1, 2, 3, 4. Where is the silicon? This is central one. See this. This is silicon. Now I write the structure of pyrosilicate. How shall I write? I write this. One oxide ion I'll shape. Yeah. O minus. O minus. This is O, which is not sharing. This is O. This is O minus, O minus, O minus, O minus, silicon atom, silicon atom. Understood? The structure of pyrosilicate. Now, some examples of pyrosilicates are, this is not a common variety of silicate. That means this type of silicates are much lesser in nature. And one such example, look here, of this type of silicate is hemimorphite. Hemimorphite is one silicate, and it is a zinc pyrosilicate, Zn. OH twice, and how many zircon? 4. Now Si2O7. Now look here, zinc 4 means 8+ star. OH twice -2. Si2O7 -6. So plus charge and minus charge are required. This is for hemimorphite. And another one is scandium silicate. This is tartarate. Silicate. Scandium is +3, no? So I will write Si2. Yes, Si2. Scandium 2 means +6. And this becomes Si2O7. Hope you have understood. So this is scandium silicate. These are pyrosilicates. And this is the next category of silicate. The next type of silicate. So now orthosilicate is over, pyrosilicate is over. Now the next type of silicate is cyclic silicates. Look here, orthosilicates, none of the oxide ions have shared. Pyrosilicates, one oxide ion or oxygen is shared. In cyclic silicate, see now what is the formula of this cyclic silicate? If you try to write Si3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, no? O, 9, charges 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 minus. Or what you can write is SiO3. 2 minus, because out of 4 minus, 2 of the oxygen have shared thrice. This is the structure. See, SiO3 thrice. In this way you can write, or you can write Si3, O9, 6 minus, because this is thrice to oxygen as well as silicon as well as charge. And how to write in this fashion? This is also one of the very important way to remember, right? Because they may ask a form, that form they may ask. So look at this, I will try to produce it. Thank you.
This is one silicon. This is another silicon. This is another silicon. Okay, this is O minus. This is O minus. This is O, shared oxygen. This is shared oxygen. And for this ring, this is O minus. This is O minus. This is shared oxygen. This is shared oxygen. O minus, O minus. This is O minus and this is shared oxygen. Now, each oxygen, each silicon has two oxide ions and two oxygens. This may be the structure of planar structure of what? A cyclic silicate with this formula Si3O9 6-. Where three silicate have formed a cyclic ring. And for this, one of the example is, well-known example is bentonite. Try to remember this name, it's very important. Bentonite is a cyclic silicate. How many oxygen are shared in this cyclic silicate? Two of the oxide ions of the silicate structures are shared. And the structure of bentonite is Ba. 2 plus titanium, 4 plus Si3O9. Ba2 plus titanium, 4 plus totally plus 6, Si3O9 is minus 6. So bentonite is one example for what? A 3 unit cyclic silicate. Another example is a 6-membered ring, cyclic silicate. I'll write here. A 6-membered ring cyclic silicate, which is having the ring structure with a 6-membered ring. I will try to produce a structure here. Look at this. Yes. So this is a central silicon atom O minus. O silicon O minus. Every silicate should have 2 O minus. And this is O. This is silicon O minus. And this is O. This is central silicon O minus. This is central silicon O minus. This is shared oxygen. This is a shared oxygen. This is the central silicate O minus. And here there is O minus. And this is the shared one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 silicates have formed the ring. This is a porous structure. Tetrahedral porous structure, remember? 6 of the silicate units are here. I will show you the central silicon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and formed a ring. And for this one of the well known example for this is beryl. Beryl is the example. Beryl is a mineral of beryllium. So what is the structure of beryl? Now what is the basic unit in this? Have you understood? Same, SiO3 2-6. of if you write it separately, SI6 O18 minus 12. Do you agree? 12 minus. SI6 O18 12 minus. And what is the formula of beryllium? Be3 plus 6 Al2 plus 6 SI6 O18 minus 12 Be3 plus 2 into 3 plus 6 Al2 plus 3 into 2 plus 6 plus 12 minus 12. So I think I have shown you all the details. SiO3 2 minus is the repeating unit. Why 2 minus? Because two of the oxygens have shared. Why pyrosilicate was having this structure? Because only one oxygen was shared. So here you have to remember. So in this, two of the oxygen atoms of each silicate is sharing, and in this also two of the oxygen atoms of each silicate is sharing, but here there are three silicate rings, here there are six silicate rings. So these are the two important cyclic silicates that have been identified, and the name, very important name, bentonite name you remember, beryl you remember, because these names are coming in your learning, second year and first year, you see. So this is all about what? Cyclic silicates. See, the next type of silicate is chain silicates. Fourth type, correct? Chain silicates. See, look here. Orthosilicate is single discrete unit of SiO4 4 minus. Pyrosilicate is sharing of one oxide ion or oxygen between two silicates Si2 O7 4 6 minus. 6 minus. Pyrosilicate. Next, I have third category. Cyclic silicates I have taken, where two of the oxygen atoms of the silicates are sharing, and I have drawn one three silicate group of cyclic silicates. For example, this is a six silicate group. And this is the cyclic silicate with the three silicate. So now, chain silicate. These three are, you know what? They are not the chain structure, polymer structure. Now, see the same units, when they continue in the form of chain, what will happen? Different silicate structure, arises. So all the silicates, that's why I am telling you, all the silicates have SiO4 4 minus as the basic unit, but depending on the next structure of oxygen uniting the silicates, varieties of silicates arises. Now chain silicate, if I take single, it is again having type single chain silicate. Single chain silicate. How many oxygen atoms these chain silicates share? They share two oxygen atoms. See, we have already formed a cyclic silicate here. Look at this. Now remove the cyclic structure, extend it. That is how. Remove the cyclic structure, extend it. Okay, I will make use of this sensor. you extend from this side. And extend from this end. Now one of the, this is O minus. Eh? O minus, this is also O minus. Now extend from this end. O minus. This is continue. I have written single chain, remember. Yes. O minus. Is this correct? So don't continue this chain. This is O minus. Continue this chain. This is single chain cyclic silicate. What is the repeating in it? Can you tell me? What is the repeating in it? O minus, O minus. SiO3 2 minus N. This is the repeating in it. Or you can write SiO3 N. You can write in this form also, remember. SiO3 bracket N 2N minus. It's also same. Okay, and for this, what is the example is diopside is an example. Diopside. So remembering all these names is important. Is a calcium and magnesium silicates. Ca Mg SiO3 2 plus 2 plus, this is 2 minus, twice A, twice. So this repetition of the chains takes place. Ca Mg, this is 2 minus, this is okay, SiO3 twice, and this is what? Diopside. And it is one such what? Silicate, which is a single chain silicate. Okay, now one double chain silicate I will draw. This is single chain silicate. Now we will go to what? A double chain silicate. I will make use of this for double chain silicate. A, B. Double chain silicate. Now, there is a structure here. Watch this. This is a double chain, discrete unit. You continue the chain. Where do you continue? Say, you continue this two. And continue this. See this? But while doing so, some of the minus charge you have removed. What was this unit? SiO3 2 minus. Now, some of the O minus becomes lesser. For example, if I write the structure, Si4 if I write, it should be 8 minus, correct? No? It should be 8 minus, but it becomes 2 of the oxides I have removed, remember. 2 of the oxides I have removed and I put O. So Si4 if I write, it should have been SiO3 12 and it should have been 8 minus 2 of the oxides you have removed, it is 6 minus. It is not 12 because sharing is the 11.
I don't know to what extent I am capable of convincing you. SiO3N is the formula for single chain silicate and 2N minus is the charge. Now when a double chain is forming, what is happening is some of the oxide ions are getting minus. And how much is minus? For every 4 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, one side and the other side. 4. If it is SiO3N formula, it should be Si4O12 and charge should have been 4 means 8 minus. But since 2O minus you have substituted by oxygen and formed a chain, this becomes 6 minus. And because of the common sharing, one oxygen give it to that chain, one oxygen you take, it becomes 11. And this is the repeating unit of what? Of double chain silicate. And you know, double chain silicates are very much common. For example, asbestos. See, asbestos is what type of silicate? If they ask, you should know this. Asbestos is a double chain silicate. What is the formula of asbestos? Ca Mg thrice O2 plus 6 minus 2 oxide, then SiO4 O11 minus 6. Hope this is correct. Si4O11. Is it right? This is the formula for asbestos. Another is there, another example is there. You know what is thermolite? Thermolite is another example, and this is also same, but with it, terms are same. Ca2Mg5OH twice hydrated. OH twice, Si4O11 also twice. Calculate the charge. Plus 4, plus 10, minus 2, minus 12. Yes. Understood? So, what is the type of silicate now? Chain silicates. What are the two types of chain silicate? Basic thing is this. How many oxygen are shared? Two oxygen atoms are shared from each silicate structures. That means you can compare it with ring silicate or cyclic silicate. Two of the oxygen atoms are not three dimensional, remember. Is it chain? How many chains I have shown you? Single chain I have shown you, that is dioxide, and double chain I have shown you. This is what? Beryl. Beryl was not a chain silicate. Beryl structure is similar to what? When it is polymerized, it becomes the asbestos structure or thermolite structure. Okay. The next type of silicate where I am going to share 3 of the oxygen atom, and finally I am going to share all the 4 oxygen of the silicate. Understand? Hope you are on the path. Now the next type. So what is the type? 4 is it? 5th category? 5th type. Yes, very important. Sheet silicate. Why it is a sheet silicate? It is having 3 of the oxygen atoms of the silicate sharing. How many? 3. It is a chain. And
and also a sheet. Three oxygen atoms of each silicate is sharing. Now look at this. When three of the oxygen atom is sharing, O minus, O minus, O minus, O minus. This minus charge has gone. This minus charge has gone. This minus charge has gone. Only one minus charge remains. And suppose if I join two people, Si2, O6 you are writing. No, no, because it is common, you know, it becomes O5. And what is the charge? 1 minus, 2 minus. So, what is the basic unit in the sheet silicate? Si2, O5, N. Or you write like this, 2 minus N. Or you can write it as Si2O5N 2N minus. Okay. I have taken a silicate, 3 of the oxygen I have shared. 3 of the oxygen when you share. I will show you what should happen now. Only centered one you leave. This also you have to share. This also you have to share. This you are sharing. This also you are sharing. This you are sharing. So you are not sharing this oxygen. That is all. Then it looks like a sheet. But still it is not called three-dimensional silicate. It is called a sheet silicate. And the example for sheet silicates are the well-known silicates. You know these names. For example, kaolin, it is called, or it is also called kaolinite, or it is also called China clay. Si2O5. So this is AlOH4, I think Al2, OH4, Si2O5, twice. Charge balance plus 3. Plus 6, minus 4. Si2O5 twice is not there. Minus 2. Plus 6. Minus 4 OH4. Si2O5 minus 2. It's correct. This is the formula for China clay, or it is called kaolinite. Remember, it is a clay. And to remember this, we are always using a formula in this way. Al2O3, 2SiO2, 2H2O. 2H2O we are using actually. But the structure wise it is like this. Water always occupy the big pores in the, you know, solid state structure, you know. Voids are occupied by, voids of the silicates are occupied by water molecules. Clay, what is clay? We call JD Mandu on the level. Mandu, clay. It, from which, you know, bricks and tiles are made. Whatever. And I can give you another two examples. For example, for sheet silicate, you know, another example is talc. Example 2. Talc. The formula of this is It's a magnesium. Mg3 OH twice plus 6 minus 2. Si2O5. Si2O5 twice. This is another, what I am silicate? Sheet silicate. What is the basic unit in sheet silicate? Yes, this is important. How this has arisen? 3 of the oxygen or silicate has been shared. It is a polymer. And what are the examples? Kaolinite, tar, mica, many more are. These are all some of the common sheet silicates. Now the last type of silicate, I think number is 5 or 6, I think, that is 3-dimensional silicate. 3-dimensional silicates. Once again I will remind you. Orthosilicate, single discrete unit, pyrosilicate, one oxygen atom is sharing and only 2 SiO4 minus are joining. Cyclic silicates, 3 units and 6 units I have given you. And then I have given you chain silicates, single chain and double chain. And then sheet silicates, and chain silicates 2 oxygen were sharing. Sheet silicates, 3 oxygen were sharing. Now the last one is 3-dimensional silicates. I think you have expected. What do you expected? All the four oxygen atoms of SiO4 minus are sharing to form a 3-dimensional silicate. And that is why when all the 4 oxygen are sharing, yes, is it not this? Then it each goes to what? Yeah, continue, like this. Yes, sir. So what is the repetition? The repetition is SiO2. Every silicon atom is surrounded by, when you on an average basis when you calculate, for each silicon atom there are 2 oxygen atoms when all the 4 are sharing. No sharing, for each silicon atom 4 oxygen atoms. When all the 4 are sharing, for each silicon atom 2 oxygen atoms. And every charge disappears, do you agree? Because when all the 4 are sharing, charge totally disappears, and this we call as sac. So 3 important examples I will give you for 3-dimensional silicate. Quartz, tridymite. One more example I will give you, which you have heard it, zeolite is also a 3-dimensional silicate. But you know what is zeolite is? Some of the silicon atoms in the network are substituted by aluminium. Plus 4 is substituted by plus 3. What will happen? Plus charge, scarcity comes. And how to manage the plus charge? By some metal ion, Na plus sodium aluminosilicate. See how nicely you can understand. It is a silicate. It is a 3-dimensional silicate. It is SiO2N. Some of the silicon atoms you are substituting by aluminium. So silicon is tetravalent, aluminium is trivalent, plus charge scarcity generates.
if that is managed by sodium or magnesium or calcium, what do you call? They are aluminosilicates. And zeolite is a naturally occurring aluminosilicate. Maybe it is sodium aluminosilicate. Understand? And it is a three-dimensional silicate. Remember, lot of porous structure is there, cavity is there, where it is a hydrated sodium aluminosilicate, where the water molecules are acquiring the pores of the aluminosilicate. So remember, what is zeolite? It is not a simple silicate, three-dimensional silicate. It is an aluminosilicate, and the charge is balanced by cations. Sodium aluminosilicate may be a common example for zeolite. Understand? So how three-dimensional silicate is formed? Sand is also a three-dimensional silicate. Remember? Or quartz, tridymite, etc. So with this, I think I have completed all the structures of silicates. Question that can be asked is, what is the basic unit? Charge and all, you have to remember. Examples, if they ask which category it belongs, etc. Please go through this class very carefully, and a few examples I will take from the old question paper, how they have asked. With this, I conclude the class. Look at some of the sample questions that have been asked in the previous year question papers. First question, which of the following anion is present in the chain structure of silicate? That means single chain and double chain structure, I have told you. Two of the oxygen atoms are shared. Si2O5N2-. No, this is a sheet silicate. SiO3N2N-. Is it correct? So this is the correct answer, yes or no? SiO44- is an orthosilicate. Si2O76- is a pyrosilicate. So therefore, what is the option? Single chain silicate is SiO3N2N-. This is the answer. If you have understood the class, this you can answer. Next, how many oxygen atoms are shared per SiO44- tetrahedral silicate anion of beryl? Beryl is a six-membered chain silicate, sorry, cyclic silicate. It is having six silicates ring structures. It is a cyclic silicate, and I told you what is the formula. When two members are shared, it is going to have the formula 6-. But because of the six-member ring, what should be the formula of that? I think two of the oxygen have been shared. Three means sheet silicate, four means three-dimensional silicate, one means pyrosilicate. So therefore, answer is C. Once again, I will tell you, four is a 3D silicate, three is a sheet silicate, one is a pyrosilicate. Name of the structure of silicate when three oxygen atoms of SiO44- are shared is called pyrosilicate? No. Sheet silicate? Is it correct? Sheet silicate. So linear chain silicate is having formula SiO3N. Three oxygens are shared means it is sheet silicate. Three-dimensional silicate is not correct. So it is the answer. Name of the structure of silicate when only one oxygen atom is shared per tetrahedron of SiO4. I have already told you. These are the question asked now. Orthosilicate, pyrosilicate. The answer is pyrosilicate. Ring silicate, none of this. Last day one question is, see this structure now. It's a polymer continuation. It's a double chain continuation. Is it not? So this is a double chain silicate. I think you understood this. In the double chain silicate, what is the repeating unit? Si4O11-6-. Si2O7-2- is a pyrosilicate. No. Si2O3, not correct. Si4O4-, this is a orthosilicate. That means SI4O11. So this is the, I think that structure is still here. It's not this detail of this one is there. So it is SI4O11, 6 minus is the correct answer. And it is what? Double chain silicate. So these are the few sample questions I have selected from the old question papers to make you convincing that this is the way question is asked. Understand? So examples also try to remember. I think with this we have completed structure of silicates. So your one demand was there to complete structure of silicates. So this I have completed today. Thank you.